The Charlotte Hornets announced that they signed Liangelo Ball. This is a guy who couldn't hit a shot at the pre-draft combine under perfect conditions, with nobody guarding him and ball boys throwing the perfect passes to him. From there, after a lot of perseverance and a 10-day stint on the Pistons, though without playing a single game, Liangelo found himself on the Hornets Summer League team this offseason. And an average of just 9.5 points over 5 games was enough for the team to sign him. I think we all know what's the real reason behind this, and that is to make their young superstar Lamelo Ball happy. He may have actually had an influence on this. And there have been a few more similar cases in the league where undeserving guys were signed directly because of a star player on that team. So let's go through them. What up everybody, my name is Stefan and this is Heat Check. Let's get into it. Did you know that Damian Lillard's cousin, Kelgen Blevins, was on the Blazers roster last year? And Portland will keep him for this season as well as a two-way player. Two-way players can play both in the G League as well as in the NBA if a team needs them and earn a flat salary close to $500,000. Though he only got extreme garbage time minutes when nothing is really impactful or taken serious, Blazer fans on Reddit swear that Blevins is one of the worst players in the league, and that there are probably better players than him on the Portland subreddit, which I thought was hilarious. Nonetheless, Damian Lillard was able to secure a big payout for his close relative. Steph Curry is also mentioned when it comes to nepotism in the NBA, and that is because of Damian Lee. Lee is actually the husband of Curry's sister, or Steph's brother-in-law, so the connection is obviously close. Unlike Blevins, however, Damian actually had an NBA-level talent, and although he went undrafted in 2016, he fought for a few 10-day contracts with different teams, eventually signing with the Atlanta Hawks for the remainder of the season. But when that contract was up, he didn't get re-signed and was pretty much back to the grind. So, this is where Golden State stepped in and offered him a two-way contract. He's been alright for them, but it's pretty obvious why he ended up on the Warriors in the first place. Next up, we got J.R. Smith's brother, Chris. As a Knicks fan, this is near and dear to me. Following the one successful season that New York had in more than a decade, a lot of players got paid and re-signed. And most of those guys deserved it. But I guess the team thought that JR was extra worthy and signed his brother Chris to a two-way contract paying him, as I previously mentioned, almost $500,000. He was able to step on the Madison Square Garden hardwood a grand total of 2 times, playing 1 minute in both games and didn't score. The only NBA footage of him is this video titled Chris Smith Real, and you can see that the highlight of his career is probably this handshake with Kevin Durant. To get an idea of how good or bad he really was, just know that after he was released by the Knicks the following season, he went to the G League and then played in Kosovo, the Kosovo Basketball League. Yeah. And of course, we gotta mention Thanasis Antetokounmpo, who most definitely ended up in Milwaukee because of Giannis. However, we have to mention here that he was also good enough to get to the NBA by himself, as the Knicks selected him with the 51st pick in 2014. However, he didn't really fulfill the expectations and was waived the next season. His next stop was a downgrade as bad as the one that Smith had. Antetokounmpo's next team was in Andorra. From there, he signed with Panathinaikos in 2017 and won the Greek National League. 2019 is when the call came from Milwaukee for reasons obvious to everyone, and Thanasis joined his brother and even has a championship ring. Last but definitely not least, an honorable mention goes to Doc Rivers, who as a general manager and coach of the Clippers, gave a 3-year, $35 million contract to a 7-point-per-game player who struggled a lot in his first 2 years on the Pelicans. Of course, Austin was more than good enough to make the league and was the number 10 draft pick. That's the story that Doc used as an excuse as well, saying that he knows just how good Austin is and all he needs is a chance to prove. And to be honest, he did prove it. He's been a solid contributing piece on a lot of teams and is now going into his 10th year in the league. The fact remains, however, that he may have been out of the league if it wasn't for his dad to sign him and play him on that Clippers team. There is also the case of Goran Dragic and his brother Zoran in Phoenix. Is there another one? Let me know in the comments. That's it for now. Subscribe and talk to you in the next one. Peace out. This is my channel. I make the rules. I make it. It counts.